Hi, welcome to Love and Forever Evolving, where we are always and forever evolving. Hello, Cappies. Welcome back, Capricorns. Welcome to your love reading. I hope all has been well, Capricorns. Hope you've been taking care of yourselves, eating plenty of root and vegetables, and taking care of that beautiful, sexy-ass temple of yours, Capricorns, as it take care of you. All right, so definitely make sure that you're eating plenty of fruits and vegetables and taking in plenty of water. All right, it is very, very important, Ashe. All right, so come on in, Cappies. We're going to see what messages source your guardian angels and ancestors have for you in regards to love, Cappies. Yes, love, love, love is in the air, Capricorns. Ashe, all right. Shout out to the evolving spirit. Shout out to the soul tribes. Thank you all so much for your love and support. I appreciate you. Your love never goes unnoticed on this channel. If you would love to become an evolving spirit like I myself, please click the join link down below. It gives you exclusive discounts on your personal readings, your email questions, and your love live stream questions, Ashe. All right. And welcome back to the ones that are new here. Thank you all for stopping by as well. All right. I love you so much. I appreciate you. Don't forget to as well like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell on your way out, my loves. All right. So, source, angels, ancestors, please protect my space and aura as I channel the messages here today for Capricorn placements. What's the messages? We're going to first start, Cappies, with the Love Romance Angel deck here, all right? Definitely stick around. I'm going to use the tarot deck, and then we'll finish up here with some word of advice from your guardian angels and ancestors, okay? All right? Source, what do we have? Protect my space and aura, most of all, my heart, as I channel the messages here today for the God and Goddesses. What do we have for the divine masculine, the divine feminine? What do their higher selves need to know in regards to love? What's going on in Cappy's love life? What do they need to know, Source? Oh, your Pandora song I got for you today, Capricorns, was by Chris Brown. It's Never a Right Time to Say Goodbye. All right, the song is called Goodbye. Okay, so there may be a breakup, a separation here from your significant other or your partner here. Someone is releasing their ex here from the past, if you haven't already, for others of you, and you're meeting someone new. All right, so just give you an FYI there. Definitely go check out the song. It's by Chris Brown called Goodbye. All right, it goes, never a right time to say goodbye. All right, so that's some of what the song is referencing to. All right. So let's see here. Let's see what's going on in your love life. The first card, let's see, what do we get out? Because this card immediately jumped out here. So let's see what we got here. Whoa, well, look at there, Cappies. New love is here. So yes, a lot of you all are saying goodbye to your past, all right? We just finished up closing out the cycle here for the retrograde energies from energies that has come back actually from the past, okay? So a lot of you all have already closed these cycles out when it comes to people in your past, lovers, ex-friends, ex-family members that you no longer associate yourself with, all right? A lot of us as a collective are cleaning out people, places, and situations that no longer resonate with our spirit and our higher selves, right? And now that you have done that, Cappies, you're making room for someone new or something new, okay, for sure here. So it says a new person, Capricorns, has steered your romantic feelings. Well, well, well. All right, that's definitely why we got that Pandora song for you for saying goodbye, okay? So a lot of you all are saying goodbye to your past, and you're welcoming in new energies here, okay? Someone new is about to be in your space, okay? You may meet this person while you're out doing your routine, at your workplace, all right? You can meet this person online, okay? There is definitely a new person here that's coming in for you all, and some of you all have already met this person here, okay? Guardian angels, what else here do we have? What else, guardian angels, when it comes to Capricorn and love life? Yes, I'm loving it. New love is here, Capricorns. What else, guardian angels, ancestors of the highest light? What else do Capricorns need to know? What else do we have here for Capricorns? Wow. Yeah, we have unrequited love here. All right. There is not enough attraction or chemistry to keep this relationship going. So this is definitely confirmation for someone here because, right, we're all different on different timelines. Excuse me. So by us being on different timelines, partial of it will resonate with you and partial of it won't, depending on where you're at on your timeline. Because when I was picking up the energies in that song while I was meditating your energy before I got ready to start your reading, Capricorn, and I like to let the song play out a little bit so I can see what messages I as well get for you when I play the song, or I just randomly select a song and whatever comes out allows me to tap into the energy that you all as a collective, as Capricorns, are in right now, right? And again, this is definitely going tie in with that song, Unrequited Love here. So a lot of you all, again, you have went through a breakup. You're going through a breakup. Some of y'all have already broken up this person a month ago, a couple of months ago, a year ago, a couple of years ago, okay, right? And now that you have done that, now this new love is coming into your life because this was a particular person from your past here where it was unrequited love here between you two. It could have been several conflicts, arguments, going back and forth, drama with each other, and you just wasn't getting along with this particular person here, and there was no chemistry here, okay? So that's why that song said, it's never a right time to say goodbye, all right? Yeah, I feel Chris Brown on that one, okay? So let's see, what else, guardian angels, ancestors, do we have for Capricorn placements? What else do we have for Capricorn placements, guardian angels, ancestors? Whoa, did you see how that card jumped out like that, Cappies? Yeah, so this is telling me that's a statement there. This is about to happen very soon for this card to jump out like this. So you're definitely about to meet this new person, Capricorns, very soon, okay? So clearly decide, Cappies, what you want so that it comes to you now, all right? Literally, it says it here on the card, okay? So, wow, you definitely have someone new coming in for you. All right, Capricorns, and what's at the bottom of the deck here? We have healing family issues. Your love life benefits as you forgive your parents, okay? So if there's a particular situation here when it comes between you and your family here, okay, allow forgiveness in your heart. Find space in your heart to forgive, okay? So that way this doesn't block you out when it comes to your love life as well here. All right, but there's definitely someone new that is coming in for you. All right, so wow, awesome. I love it so far, Capricorns. Definitely, if you love it as well, don't forget to hit that big fat thumbs up. Show spirit some love. All right, again, if you're new here, my loves, welcome, welcome. Subscribe, my loves. Be a part of family. This is where we love and we evolve each and every day here on this platform. All right, and definitely don't forget to click that notification bell so that way you are notified for when I do post your readings here on this platform every 2 days, and also when I go live, my loves, all right? So make sure to have your notification bell set there, okay? All right, so let's now pull out the tarot deck. We're going to get further clarification here and dig a little deeper beneath the surface when it comes to your love life. Guardian angels, what else we have? What are the messages here for Capricorn placements do they need to know here in regards to the messages source? What else do we have here for Capricorns? What else do they need to know, guardian angels, ancestors of the highest light? Wow, thank you. We have the Ace of Swords, air energy here. Some of y'all, this person could be an air sign here. We have Aquarius, Gemini, and Libra energy here. But this card talks about getting clarity and getting truth when it comes to a situation here or a circumstance here. All right, and this also is stating that everything that I've said here is the truth. And this is what is going to occur in your life, Capricorns, here. Some of y'all might meet this person here. Yep, that's another statement here. Some of y'all may meet this person here in the next couple of days here in the month of June. All right, sometime this summer you may meet this new person here. All right, and others of you may meet this person before the year is up here, okay? All right, and someone is not too much happy about that because this card wanted to flip over while it was in my hand here as if someone wanted to knock it out of my hand. So you're going to have other energies around you that is not going to be happy about this union or this person that's coming in, and I'm sure that may be the ex here, Okay, it's funny how the card is standing over this card here and it wanted to flip out my hand. So someone is not going to be happy because you decide that you want to move on, right? You want better for yourself, and I don't blame you. What else, guardian angels, ancestors, do we have here for Capricorn placements? What else do they need to know, source? What else do we have for Capricorn placements? Guardian angels, ancestors of the highest light. Thank you. Yeah, wow. Look at this. I knew it. There's definitely an energy in here right now with me that's not happy. Capricorns, I'm going to be honest with you. All right? Because we have the Eight of Swords coming out here as well. This card talks about guilt, regrets, disappointments, things of that sort. This person is still sitting here crying over spilled milk. They're in this puddle of water and they know they can move themselves out of this water, but they're choosing not to. So this could be someone also that's very stubborn, Capricorns, and not wanting to admit to the things that they know they have done wrong here, because they have all these swords standing around them, okay? And they have definitely known what it is that they have done, but they are choosing not to fix the situation. They're choosing not to look into the situation. They rather allow their blindfold to be wrapped around them where they don't have to see it themselves or face themselves in the mirror. This is that type of energy that could be that narcissistic energy as well when it comes to, you know, admitting things and allowing themselves to evolve here. Okay, wow, Capricorns. Let's get one more card here. And that's in reference to this unrequited love here. So it's definitely time for you to release this ex here. Okay, some of y'all could have even been in a marriage or a relationship for years with this person here. Could even been over 8 years or 8 months here with this particular person here that has just, you know, done things that you wasn't happy with, that you didn't agree with when it comes to getting in a committed relationship or marriage here with. This person could have betrayed you on so many levels and done things here that wasn't, you know, satisfying for you or the relationship here. It's why now it's like I'm hearing well overdue. This relationship, this foundation here that you have built with this person is now coming down because it was well overdue. Yes, we have the High Priestess here. This is Pisces energy here. Some of you all, this person might be a Pisces here, all right? Some of you all, this person may be just very intuitive. Okay, and this tells me that when this card comes out for me, that everything that I'm saying here, Capricorn, you already knew, all right? And you know, okay? And this person knows as well here because this is just confirming this Eight of Swords. So this tells me that they know everything that they're doing to you. They knew everything that they did in regards to this relationship is why they're sitting here in the Eight of Swords energy in all this guilt. Because they know everything that they did to hurt you or to cause a situation to get up to this point where it's unrequited love between you two. Wow, Cappies. Yeah. And look at you now. You're ready to take a leap of faith here. All right. You're starting back over at the number zero here. You see all this yellow here in the background talks about fresh new start here. Because like I said, someone is coming in for you if they haven't come in for you already. Some of y'all have already met this person here. You've already got acquainted with this person here for a couple of months here now. Okay. And now you two are ready and going to the next level. Okay. Wow, Cappies. All right. Definitely, again, if the reading is resonating, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Oh, my goodness. All right. So let's see how this particular person or the energies externally outside of you are feeling towards you at this time. I'm going to use a Hidden Truth Oracle deck here for you, Cappies. So it's what do we have for the energies that are outside of Capricorns? How do these particular energies feel towards Capricorns? What are the certain energies that are surrounding Capricorns at this time? How do they feel towards Capricorn placements, guardian angels, ancestors? Whoa. All right, so let's see what we got here. We have, wow, I love you, Capricorns, okay? So I feel like this is coming more from this energy here that's coming in here that some of you all, like I said, have already engaged yourself with here. This person is now realizing that they love you, Capricorns. Yes, they love you, all right? Or they're gonna be in love with you, okay? Wow, and then this is this other energy here. It was my fault, but I blame you, Capricorn. Yep, this is this energy right here. Okay, this is all what these Eight of Swords here is talking about here, right? It was my fault, Capricorns, but I blame you. And this is that blame card, okay? Definitely blame you and themselves, okay? Instead of wanting to blame themselves, they always project this out on you and blame you for their life being the way that it is. Blame you for not being able to be successful and do things that they wanted to do. Blame you because the way how they may look or the situation that they're currently in. Just a blame game there, right? Wow. And then we have, I look for you everywhere, Cappies. Okay. So this particular energy here, like I said, for the ones that haven't met this person, they're manifesting you. And I feel like you are manifesting this person here as well. All right. Yeah. We have, I will wait for a sign from you. So this person is waiting, Capricorns. They're waiting to hear from you first. Or they want to make sure they hear a sign for you before they move forward here. Or they're just waiting to, you know, remove themselves from a situation here. I feel like just as much as you are here, because there's unrequited love here. So I feel like you two may or even aware of situations that's going on with each other in your past here. All right. And so I feel like you two are waiting for a sign from each other to move forward here, because this person could have went through the same situation where they're dealing with the unrequited relationship or marriage here. So they're trying to better themselves and wait on you, whoever this person is that's going to be new in your life as well. All right, I feel like you two are similarity situations here. Okay, wow, that's very significant. Okay, so let's see how this particular energy feels towards you, this new love that's coming in. I'm going to use my raw tarot deck here before we close out your spread, and then we'll use the oracle deck here to get some spiritual advice from your guardian angels and ancestors. Okay, again, if the reading has resonated, don't forget to like, subscribe, and definitely hit the notification bell. I am so excited to see where the energies here go with you two in the next 2 days here, Cappies. Wow, beautiful reading here. What other messages in regards to this particular new energy that's coming in that wants to tell Capricorns? Well, thank you. What do we have? We have, wow, Cappies. Take all your clothes off. Oh my goodness, this person is not wasting any time. All right, so some of y'all have gotten to that next level here, which I would not be surprised. Look at how you two are all up on each other, or gonna be up all up on each other here, okay? Baby, this person is very, very attractive to you as well, Capricorns here. Wow, we have, you are my everything. Again, everything. Everything. Not only does this person look for you everywhere, Capricorns, but they see you as their everything. Like, you complete this person in so many ways here. Oh my gosh, what's at the bottom of the deck? So what? That's my baby. Oh, so this person is claiming you. Like I said, they don't care how people may have treated you or talked to you, or, you know, have, as you express yourself to this person here. And this person could have even gotten messages from other people in your family or people that you may have worked with or any of that. And they may have said negative things about you, I feel, Capricorns. But this person, this new person that's coming in, they're like, so what? That's my baby. I don't care what you have to say about my Capricorn. That's my baby. That's my Capricorn, right? Wow, that is so sweet, Cappies. Oh, all right. So let's get you some word of advice here to finish up your beautiful spread here today. Wow, Capricorns. All right. Guardian angels. Wow, we already had a card jump out. Let me get a shuffling to get another card for you. All right. We just have cards jumping out from left and right. Okay. What else, Guardian angel? What word of advice here can Capricorn placements take away from this spread here today? Guardian angels, ancestors of the highest light, what messages do we have here for Capricorns in this connection here? What word of advice, guardian angels, ancestors of the highest light? What can they take away from this beautiful spread? Give me one more card. Can I please have... Whoa. Okay, we have several cards there. Okay, at the bottom of the deck, wow, yes, we have peaceful resolution, all right? So this situation is going to be a peaceful resolution between you and this person here, okay? So no need to worry there, all right? The first card jumped out. Wow, again, look for a sign, Cappies, okay? Your guardian angels is really trying to lead you in the direction here of this new person, of this new cycle, this new adventure that you're about to go on, okay? So make sure that you're following your intuition and using your discernment here with the high priestess energy here, okay? And wow, we have no, okay? So in regards to you and this unrequited love here, okay, I advise for you to move forward and don't look back, and even your guardian angels here, okay, when it comes between you and that particular person here. Yes, you know why? Because you have opportunity coming towards your way here, okay? And I would hate for you to miss out on this opportunity here when it comes to this new love, when it comes to this new fresh start that you have coming towards your way here. Okay, yes, and we have if you believe, okay? If you believe, then absolutely this person will come in. This will be manifested for you, but you have to have faith, all right, Capricorns? Don't give up when it comes to your love life. Yes, we have helpful people, all right? So your guardian angels and ancestors are going to send you helpful people, all right, that's going to be able to help you along your journey here, all right? Wow, yes, I can't make this up. That's confirmation as well. All right. So, yes, you're going to have helpful people. Yes, this is going to be a new opportunity for you. All right. And yes, you have new love coming in here. Yes. Wow. Ask your angels. Okay. So don't be afraid. Send your prayers out. Send your affirmations out as well. All right. Wow, Capricorns. Again, if the reading has resonated with your spirit and your higher self, don't forget to like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. All right. And also, if you're new here, don't forget to click that join link down below. It gives you exclusive discounts on your personal readings, your email questions, and your love live stream questions when I go live, my love. Thank you all so much for your continuous love and support. And congratulations, Capricorns. All right. Enjoy this new cycle and cycle of love. All right. I love you, Capricorns. You take care. Mwah. Bye-bye.